Aristotle is giving his theory of law, he is criticizing Plato's theory of philosopher king. According to Aristotle, law is the true reason, not the passion. So here, passion kya hai? Philosopher king. And on the other hand, when we are talking about law, तो law क्या है आपका? Law and order. यहाँ पर आप इसको क्या बोल सकते हो? Government या फिर state. Plato has particularly said that no law or ordinance is greater than the philosopher king. So Plato has made the philosopher king primary or has given priority over the law and order. No, Aristotle here criticizes Plato by saying that the law and order, when we talk about the law and order, it is impersonal in nature. Since Plato is talking about passion, philosopher king, अब प्लेटो का ये मानना है the quality soul, the most qualitative soul, men of gold, they will become the philosopher and one philosopher will become the philosopher king or queen. It is actually the wisdom of a single person. And even when we are talking from the soul perspective, like Plato used to say, तो Aristotle क्या कहते हैं? Aristotle कहते हैं कि अगर soul जो है inside the body होती है, तो reason जो होता है, law is reasonable. तो that is outside the body in the form of book. So we don't know what is inside our body, you know, per se, because it is intangible. बट वो जो बुक है वो टेंजिबल है, वी कैन इम्प्लाई इट. वो सिर्फ हमारी सोच में निर्भर नहीं होती, उसको हम एक्चुअल में इम्प्लाई कर सकते हैं, उसमें हम रिफॉर्म्स ला सकते हैं, उसको हम बेटर कर सकते हैं. सिंस एरिस्टोटल हैज स्टडीड 158 कॉन्स्टिट्यूशंस, सो एरिस्टोटल हैज वेरी फर्मली बिलीव दैट लॉ इज इम्पर्सनल इन नेचर. इम्पर्सनल क्या हुआ? इट इज इनडिफरेंट, इट इज न्यूट्रल, इट इज जस्टिसिएबल. जस्टिस क्या है? व्हेन यू आर नॉट बायस्ड इन एनी पर्सन्स फेवर. फिलोसोफर किंग डज हैव एपेटाइट ऑल्सो अमंग द अदर थ्री एलिमेंट्स. रीजन तो बस डोमिनेटिंग है ना, लेकिन स्पिरिट भी है और कहीं ना कहीं एपिटाइट भी है. आज नहीं तो कल वो एपिटाइट हावी हो जाएगा. देन द फिलोसोफर किंग, सो कॉल्ड फिलोसोफर, द इमेजिनेबल फिलोसोफर किंग विल नॉट बी इम्पर्सनल. एंड अगेन एरिस्टोटल सेज दैट व्हेन वी आर टॉकिंग अबाउट द लॉ, व्हेन वी आर टॉकिंग अबाउट द कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन, तो जब हम लॉ की बात करते हैं, लॉ एंड ऑर्डर की बात करते हैं, इट इज द कलेक्शन ऑफ द विजडम ऑफ एजेस. 158 कॉन्स्टिट्यूशंस. इवन व्हेन वी टॉक अबाउट द फॉर्मुलेशन ऑफ द इंडियन कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन, the forefathers of our Indian constitution, they have studied around 60 constitutions. After that, they have borrowed the features from certain number of constitutions. So, kahin na kahin kya hai? We have also relied upon the wisdom of ages. Although we had great leaders like Jawaharlal Nehru, Sardar Vallabh Bhai Patel, M.N. Roy bhi the, phir hamare Mahatma Gandhi ji bhi the, Bose bhi the. Jab itne leader the, itne mahaan leader the, still the Constituent Assembly never relied upon their wisdom. They relied upon the wisdom of ages. You know, this is actually very practicable here. What Aristotle is talking about. So Aristotle is very, you know, clearly saying that law is same as, you know, both have same purpose. Law guide bhi karega aapko and at the same time, law aapko ye bhi batayega ki what should you do and what you should not do. So law kya hai? The only difference between the reason is that it is inside the soul and law is outside the, aur asli reason kab hoga? When it is outside the soul, because it is implementable. At the same time, Aristotle is criticizing Plato. According to Plato, no law or ordinance is above the philosopher king. So Plato is basically preferring the wisdom of a very single person, which is not very, you know, consistent or logical if we see. It is better to rely upon the wisdom of ages rather than the wisdom of just one person, and that also who might develop appetite at certain point. So when we discuss the theory of law, actually it is a direct attack by Aristotle upon the philosopher king concept of the Plato.